The Education of Frederick Fitzel. I hope I'm saying that right. I was suggested this by Storm Shadow. Thank you for your first great recommendation, The Adventures of Wolf Boy. It looks really good. I'm definitely going to see it. So I'm excited to watch this one because that was a really good first recommendation. Let's just jump in. I don't know what this is about. I guess education's involved and a guy named Frederick. Let's see.
I don't want to be like them. Locked in a prison they forgot that they're in.
What prison?
So, Fred Fitzel, where Fitzel. Do you see yourself in 5 years?
I know that guy.
Fred.
Do you remember Cindy?
Cindy?
From high school.
She hasn't even crossed my mind in 15 years.
I do remember Cindy Williams. She just vanished. That was when that
they killed her.
Drug went round the school.
I'll tell you what I do remember. First time you tried Merc.
What does it do to you?
Sit back. Enjoy the show.
Oh, that does not look like a fun drug. There actually are no fun drugs.
I think I've had some kind of flashback. It's just one night we were on Merc. Can't shake the feeling that something bad happened to her. We gotta go back. We gotta try to remember what happened to her that night.
Oh, so she's kind of like stuck in purgatory, I guess? It's one of those where she has unfinished business.
I swear it happened.
Whatever you do, just don't take it. It's not what we think it is.
What's gonna happen to me?
Oh, Dylan O'Brien.
There's so much to explore if you don't succumb to pleasure or fear.
That was a creepy little musical tune there at the end. This is why I love YouTube, this wonderful community. I kept skipping over that trailer. I don't know why, but I did. And you, Storm Shadow, brought me back to it. And it looks really freaking good. It reminded me almost of Stir of Echoes, one of my favorite freaking horror movies ever. I love Stir of Echoes. Love me some Kevin Bacon. Who doesn't like bacon? All kinds. But it reminded me of that because throughout the whole movie, he keeps seeing this ghost, and it's kind of like a, like, figure out the ghost mystery story, unfinished business. You have to get her soul back to where it's supposed to be, or send it to where it's supposed to be kind of thing. So you have to figure out what's going on, and I feel like that's what's going on here. It's like he keeps seeing her, so he tells his friends, like, we gotta investigate and find out what happened to her. When you said Dylan O'Brien after you suggested this, I was thinking a director for some reason. Dylan O'Brien's Thomas in The Maze Runner. He's my Maze Runner buddy. I love The Maze Runner. He's great in that. I love Thomas in that. This kid has acted in, like, I think it said 19 different things on his IMDb. That's not that many. And I think his first was 2011, I think. And I'd never heard of it. I want to say it was a movie. So it's doing pretty good, I have to say. In Love and Monsters. He's in Love and Monsters. I reviewed Love and Monsters not too long ago. This looks really, really good. This looks really interesting. It looks really, really freaking creepy. That was a good one. I'm gonna put it on my list for sure. That looked really cool. I like how it was filmed too, in that dark kind of wanna hide and snuggle somewhere feeling, because it was filmed with all these really shadowy kind of no light whatsoever scenes. I really like that. I love when movies go all in like that. Your show, I can't remember what I was just watching not too long ago, and I was watching the making of it, and they were saying that they specifically shot certain scenes with a lot of bright light and certain scenes with no light at all to signify life and death. And you didn't know that little twist until the end. And then you go back and you think and you're like, oh my God, like, yeah, like, and I forget, like, the one person always wore bright colors and the other person always wore dark colors. It's little things like that that really create the whole feel. I like the way it was filmed. I like the way it looked. And I like the story and I like the cast. The girl, she looked familiar, but I didn't recognize her from anything. She seemed like a cool ghost girl from what I saw. Yeah, I'm definitely putting it on my list. That looks good. I can't believe I actually have passed that up for so long and haven't seen it yet. So thank you again, Storm Shadow. Awesome recommendation. I really appreciate it. If you got any more, throw them my way. And if you guys could like and subscribe, hit the bell somewhere around this vicinity, that would be great. If you have any suggestions, let me know. Write them down in the comments and I will do them. And I think that's about it. I'm gonna go look up scary things to do tonight. I want to do a drive-through scary haunted house thing. I'm a wimp. I love horror movies, love scary movies, but you will not catch me walking through a haunted house. Do not touch me. There's a bubble, okay? Bubble around. Do not breach that freaking bubble. Don't touch me. Don't come near me. Don't throw a chainsaw on my face. I will throw a mean left hook, I promise you. And I'm a righty, so think about how that one would hurt. That's why I want to do a drive-in thing or drive-through thing, because then I'm safely in the bubble of my car and I could run them over if I need to. All right, enough ranting. Thank you, Storm Shadow, for your recommendation. Happy Saturday. Bye.